Now we will take care of our second workflow that we did, and once more we will go into File, Automate and Batch. And here we want to have the default action and now our workflow 2 with the patch correction. And everything else stays the same. So it's with the opened file, stop for errors, and the destination is none. And we press OK. And isn't this awesome? I mean, you maybe wonder why did we have a whole action for just this one layer? But now we don't have to go through every image and just say, okay, layer, here please a layer, here please a layer. So Photoshop did this all for us, just with this one time where we had to create the action. And then with the batch processing, now all of those images have the same patch correction. So here we go in and say, okay, we want to maybe soften anything else or get rid of anything. I think her skin looks here pretty good already. Maybe I want to eliminate some of those. So we just drag this anywhere where we think it makes sense, where the skin seems fitting. And then I just go through this fairly fast. Maybe we get rid of this here, just down. If you want to minimize any lines, then you can do this here too. And let's say, let's get rid of this one, and that's okay. And then we just lower this opacity down so it looks more natural. Maybe 64 should be okay. And yeah, if you want to get rid of this painted tattoo, then obviously now is a chance as well, because that's fairly easy with the patch tool. But I just leave it like this for now. And go into the next image and say, here I want to maybe minimize all of those wrinkles a lot. And just bring this over here and this one down there, and then maybe these lines up here. And I just drag this to the spot where I think the skin looks good. So this should be all right. And maybe even with this one, and then I can zoom out, see if there's anything else. Maybe just lighten this also, because now I want to just reduce the opacity because I don't want it so extreme. Maybe like this. And this doesn't have to be only the patch correction. You could obviously also go in and say, okay, what else do I want to do here? Is there anything where I can have some correction? And I think this area here is overall too dark. So with my eye tool, with eye, I just go on this tool and have this little picker here. Oops. Yeah. And then I just say with B for brush and a very small opacity, I can also just lighten this area. Keep in mind that we are now here on this reduced opacity, so you can probably paint over this a few times without affecting it too much. Okay, this should be pretty good. Okay, and let me zoom out once more to see maybe if we get more in, maybe more about 70 before after. Yeah, I think that's actually too strong. I go maybe 55. Yeah, I think that's nice. Now we just minimize these little wrinkles. And here I just do the same. I just go over this area fairly fast. Just drag this down. Anything up here. Maybe this line. Bringing this down. Up here. Maybe even this tiny line there. And this should be okay. Then I just get a bit down here again with the opacity, maybe about also 55 if I go before after. Yeah, I think that's good. Just minimize, and then I can also paint maybe a tiny bit over this with like a 30% opacity, just to brighten this area also. Okay, I think this should be all right for now. And then with the next one, we just do the same thing one more time, just painting over this. Or first we do our patch tool, dragging this somewhere where the skin is good, and then one more time here. Okay, and maybe the line here, something like this. And now this is obviously again too extreme. We can maybe even get rid of this line like that. You can even go ahead if you don't like the skin up here. You could even drag it all the way where the skin you think is maybe better. And now this looks obviously terrible, it's too extreme. But if we just drag this down, maybe again around 55 seems to be a good value here. Yeah, that's probably okay. We minimized also this glossier or this shine. That's a bit up to you if you want to keep this or not. You can always obviously have the mask back on here and paint areas out where you went a bit overboard or thought it might be too crazy. And then we can also just minimize this here a little bit. Yeah, I think that's good. So overall, that's now our correction with the patch layer. And now we will go back into the file and automate once more, because now we want to have a look at our third workflow here, and this will be the frequency separation.